Hello, you guys. So today I'm going to be cleaning out my cubby here, and it's got all of my K-beauty, Korean beauty products, and these four bomb barrels in the back. So I'm going to turn the camera around now and show you. I'm going to clean all this out and take everything out, dust everything, and then put everything back. But I wanted to show you what I have in these four bomb barrels behind me. So today I'm cleaning out my bomb barrel cubby, and I'll show you what that means in a minute. And inside of that cubby I have a lot of they're called bomb barrels, and I keep my rose jam things in those bomb barrels. So these are literally all of the things, with the exception of one thing, that Lush has ever made with the rose jam fragrance. And I did, just for fun, I cleaned out my cubbies so that I can do a rose jam scent family portrait like I do on Instagram and my blog. And so I thought, well, I'll just record it. I'll record myself just putting everything back and stuff after my photo, just to make a video, because I don't know, you guys might find it interesting. So these are all the rose jam fragrance items. So let's go check it out. So we have what started it all. I believe it was Rose Argan body conditioner right here. And they sell that in all of the stores now and online. And next to that is the very exclusive rose jam jelly made in the Lush kitchen at lush.co.uk/kitchen a few months, actually about a year ago. And then we have the rose jam shower gel, which is sold for Christmas. And then also available in the Lush kitchen were these rose jam scented soaps, and the soaps are called centenary soaps. They're called centenary soaps. And then the round one in the middle is the shampoo bar, a solid shampoo bar called Jason and the it's called Jason and the Argan Oil. And next to that, that little round guy is a solid perfume of rose jam, also made in the Lush kitchen. And above that is a Lush spray perfume, also available as an exclusive at the lush.co.uk website in the Lush kitchen. And catty corner from that right here is the rose jam body spray. And the big bath bomb next to that is the giant rose bombshell. And next to that is the regular size rose bombshell. And above that is the original style rose bombshell. And down from there is the naked version of this. It's the naked version of the Rose Argan body conditioner. And to the left of, or next to that, is the massage bar called Pearl Jam, or called Pearl. And underneath that is a long cylindrical yellow bath bomb called Sparkler, and it's full of gold glitter. And underneath that is the bubble bar. It's a called Rose Jam Bubble Rune, and they sell that in all of the stores and online now. And to the right of that is a butterfly, and it's also, there's another one right here that's wrapped. This one's unwrapped, and it's on a stick. It's a reusable bubble bar on a stick, and it's called Madam Butterfly. And then this big chunk that's wrapped right here is a rose jam piece of gourmet soap. And the pieces of rose are also soap, but they're not gourmet soap style. They're regular soap style. And so, yeah, so that's everything there. These are my bomb barrels that I was telling you about. And so these are what I keep all my rose jam things in when I store them in my cubbies, in my shelves. So, like this one has some extra rose jam bubble runes, original style rose jam bubble runes, and another original style rose bombshell bath bomb. Aside from the ones that I just showed you, I had some in there, just spare. And so now I'm gonna dust these off and clean the inside of them and dust my shelf and then put everything back. But here is the most current one. It says, Lush, want not, what not. Waste not, want not. Bath ballistic, whatnot. It will perfectly preserve your bath treats in a steamy atmosphere. In other words, you shouldn't store your bath bombs and bath products in the bath because the steam from the bath actually is a detriment. It makes the colors fade, it makes the texture of them kind of funky, and they don't keep as well. So I never keep my stuff in the bathroom. But if you have no choice, then you should keep them in one of these because then the steam and stuff doesn't get to them. This one's called My Pillar of Fizz. And this is made from recycled black pots. It says, this storage barrel for bath ballistics is made out of black pots returned by Lush customers. Isn't that cool? So that's what I store my stuff in. That's this one, and then when there's this one, it's an older one called the Bomb Barrel. And then this is even older, and this one is called the Bath Tube, and it has hand-drawn customer drawings on it of bath bombs, honeybee bath bomb right there, and sex bomb bath bomb right there, and big blue bath bomb right there, isn't that cool? And then this one is even older, and that one also has hand-drawn stuff from the customers on it. The bath tube. Isn't that cool? So, for instance, here's a bath bomb, and so I just put it in there. And then it goes to the bottom, and then I put the lid on. But I'll put soaps in there, shower gel, and bath bomb. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this, and we'll talk to you on the next video, you guys. Bye-bye.